Hi YouTube, this is Michigan Snow Pony Urbanae, and I'm going to show you something that I make. Well, I go in spurts, but I've made it a lot, and I got the idea from Mary Jane's farm. She also has a website, Mary Jane Butters. She's out in Utah, does an organic freeze-dried and dried food line, and also encourages the farm girl connection. And so just go online and check her out. But she does this thing, and this is an old magazine, but in the early days she called it, I'm not going to say this right, tartien. And it's a one skillet meal, basically. Isn't that beautiful? This one has black beans, red and green bell peppers, onions, and cheddar cheese paired with one of her mixes. And I started making these and just fell in love with them. I have ordered her mixes. They're very good. They're all organic, but they're pricey, as you might guess. And so I looked for a way to do these without having to buy the mix. And what I discovered is my homemade biscuit mix works, my homemade cornbread recipe works, and so do these little mixes. So we're going to make a tartien, or as she calls it now, this is a newer version of her magazine, a bakeover. So let's get started. Now you're going to need 4 cups approximately, I always go over, of vegetables and or meat, and 2 teaspoons of oil, and one of those little baking mixes or a recipe of your own, biscuit or cornbread mix. And what you're going to do first of all is you're going to saute it in a pan. Now, this pan happens to be one of Mary Jane's, and it's all metal because you're going to go from the stovetop into a 425 degree oven. So as long as you have a pan that will do that, you can use it. This one retails, it's a 9-inch, it retails for $25 from her website, Mary Jane's Farm, MaryJaneJanesFarm.com. You'll find her on the line. And she also has a larger version, which is an 11-inch, and that retails for, I think, $37. It's pretty well made. Let me just show you what it does here. I've got to put my camera down a minute. It's actually like a camp skillet. The handle folds down for storage. Isn't that nice? And then you just flip it right out when you want to use it. Gotta make it click here. One-handed, it's so fun. Anyway, you get the idea. And it's kind of wok-shaped, what you want. You want kind of a rounded, deep dish. Now, you can use cast iron, but cast iron is heavy, and towards the end of the video I'll show you what happens when you use cast iron. I'm laughing because I'm already thinking about it, but anyway, this one's really lightweight and works really well for this recipe. So let's go back to making our ingredients, or putting our ingredients together rather. What I'm using for this particular bakeover are some sweet onions, and I'm leaving them kind of big and loopy. Some red potatoes, excuse me, and some sweet potatoes. You could use carrots, cauliflower, asparagus, whatever you like. You just mix and put together your own creations. And I'm also adding ham. Now this happened to be some frozen ham I had, but you could definitely use your canned ham or your canned meat. This lends itself to that very well. Like I say, I always cut up and get out too much, and then I do something else with it. So think 4 cups. This is way more. And I also have a little dish of leftover peas I'm going to throw in there for color. So the first thing you're going to do, and I've already started, is you're going to put your little few teaspoons of oil in your pan and heat it up. And you're just going to saute your vegetables for about 3 to 5 minutes. Now I should wait till that oil is nice and hot, but I'm not going to. If you want gourmet, you got to go to somebody else's channel that knows what they're doing. I do what I want. And I'm going to kind of gauge this. I'm going to add the ham last because it's cooked ham. So, and we're going to cook this in the oven besides, so I don't really need to do that. Main thing is to cook up or saute the raw vegetables. You can add your own seasonings, whatever seasonings you want. And after we get this done, sauteed, you can add a layer of cheese to the top. I think that's going to be about right because by the time I add the ham. So I'm going to saute this up and we'll come back. Okay, well, our vegetables are sizzling away. I'm going to mix up my little Jiffy mix according to directions. So I've added an egg and a third cup of milk. And I'm just going to mix that up and we'll come back. Okay, my vegetables have been sautéed and my onions went translucent. So I'm going to add my ham. Yes, my hands are clean. And I can mix this in or I can just make a layer of ham. I've done it both ways. I think I'll leave it as a layer. Oh, I could have added a little more vegetables. No, maybe not. And I forgot my peas, so I'm just going to sprinkle peas around it. Just for color. And use them up. Couple on the floor for the dogs. Now, here's the fun part. Here's my cornbread mix. I'm going to spatula that on top. I've got my oven heating up to 425 degrees. So I've put you down to do that, and we'll come back when I get my cornbread mix on top. Okay, I usually make this with my own cornbread. It's been so long since I used a mix that I forgot I mixed two of them, because one doesn't quite cover this. So there's a little correction there. So I'm going to go ahead and spread the second one on top, and then we'll get it in the oven. Now we're just going to pop it in the oven, 425 degrees, for 20 minutes to a half an hour. Just, I find it varies a little bit by how full you make it. And then when we take it out, we're going to put a plate on top and flip it out. And it's really pretty. So we'll be back. Okay, I just took it out of the oven. And now I'm going to put a plate on top and flip it over and show you what that looks like. Okay, here's the unveiling. Oops, one for the dogs. No, yeah, it's hot. Someone's gonna get a surprise. There you go. Isn't that pretty? And I'm just
very pretty.
Oh, and it's still steaming hot. And I'm just gonna take some parsley flakes and sprinkle on top. You know, because presentation is everything around here. And there you go. Now, before I take it to the table, let me just show you the downside. I can touch this already. The downside of using cast iron. You can use cast iron, but because it's heavy, it's a little hard to do this with. Let me just show you. Okay.
Ready?
Yeah. You get a tap on presentation. Flop. But anyway, that's a do-over, it's a bake-over. Try not to throw it on the pan, it tends to work much better.
Mom has her salsa chips.
Yeah, but don't make a meal of them. All right, I'll get you something to cut it. Now, you could also add cheese on top at this point, and it would melt because it's still steaming. And if you want to do a different kind of crust, you could use a biscuit crust and maybe add Italian seasoning, use Italian sausage and peppers and tomatoes. I mean, you can really play around with this recipe a lot. You can also add cheese to a biscuit crust before you bake it. So this is really a fun one-pot meal to mess around with, and just use what you have on hand, and it looks so impressive. If my one potato hadn't fallen on the floor, it looks so impressive when you take it to the table and you unveil it. Everybody's gonna go ooh ah, and it's an easy peasy one-pot meal.
Smells good.
Yep. Hopefully it'll taste good too. I'll show you when it's cut on the plate.